If the last remaining restrictions are about to be lifted. Let's go to Sarah Gerethy, who's in glitter ball heaven tonight in Sydney's inner west. Sarah, how soon before people can dance the night away?
Well, Anita, the Imperial has very kindly turned on the lights here for the ABC tonight, but the glitter ball won't be able to start spinning in earnest until next week. Now, dance floors like this one have been gathering dust for about a year now because of the restrictions of COVID-19. But come 1 minute past midnight on Monday, a raft of those restrictions are being lifted. Now, that includes no limits on singing or dancing anywhere, no caps on weddings or funerals. Entertainment venues will be able to operate at 100% seated capacity, and mask wearing will become optional on public transport, although it is still highly recommended. Now, the Treasurer, Dominic Perrottet, says this almost returns New South Wales to normal, and he says that's a huge feat considering that just last year the state was closing Bondi Beach.
To be here today and have New South Wales opened up in circumstances where, particularly in places across Europe, they're still in lockdown. So to have the freedoms and the opportunities we have is a testament to the people of our state.
We already were planning a party 10 minutes after that, and we'll be opening with a dance floor this next Thursday. And I just cannot wait to open the doors to close to normal trading conditions again.
Now, people who want to hit the dance floor, Juanita, will still have to scan their QR codes on entry to these venues. And the government is urging people with cold and flu symptoms to still keep getting tested for COVID-19 and definitely not to go out if they're feeling unwell. And they say this is essential if people across New South Wales want to cut their finest moves on the dance floor.
Sarah Gerethy, thank you.